Fantasy 16. Today we are going back to Norway. Yeah. Yeah. The origin.
I need to tell everyone what happened to Drake's spine. And I'm going to need Otto's help.
There's something about it.
Still alive, Otto? Something tells me that eyesore on the horizon is your doing. How'd you manage that?
It's a long story.
It's Ultima.
Right. All hands on deck then.
It's Ultima. You're Ultima, that's me.
Is this everyone?
Yeah. Everyone important.
As I'm sure you've all guessed, the crystal which now commands the eastern skies was summoned by Ultima. He called it Origin. Now the significance of that name is as yet unclear.
What does it matter what it's called? Its emergence tore Twinside asunder and wiped my homeland from the map.
Yeah.
Mention of the Dominion spires can be found in the oldest of Valisthian records. But to the best of my knowledge, none provide any hint as to their true nature. That they would prove the horns of some slumbering demon. Well,
the Dominion's demise was at least quick. Elsewhere, the Republican army cannot hope to contain the chaos engulfing Randalar. Canva is in flames, and the Empire.
Our allies are crying out for answers. I've sent the Cursebreakers to give them what assurances we can, but right now that amounts to fuck all.
They wouldn't be able to stop what the skies have started in any case. People here and across the realm grow sicker with every passing day. Could it be that this new mother crystal is like the others? That it draws upon the land's ether? It certainly looked that way from Stonehill.
Probably.
If that were true, it would explain the hastening spread of the blight since the crystal's appearance, would it not?
And as the land's ether slowly rises to the surface, it pools. Corrupting all who cannot channel its energies. Arcay above, ether floods below, and in the middle, here we languish, hopelessly entrapped.
It's all right.
When we faced him at Stonehill, Ultima told us his true power quickens in the halls of Origin. Needless to say, we cannot allow that to continue. If we are to stop him, we will have to find a way into the crystal.
How are we going to manage that then? It's up in the sky. And fast as she is, the Enterprise can't fly.
Yep.
It's a lot to take in. And I reckon we'd all benefit from some time to clear our heads. The answer will come to us. Don't you worry. Ain't that right, Clive?
Right. That's right.
Well, go on then. Bugger off. Same goes for you, Clive. You won't solve anything like this. Trust me. Go and get some fresh air, right?
Sure.
Thank you.
Joshua seemed upset.
What's up, Joshua? What's up?
Ultima may have created us, but he doesn't make us who we are. Only we can do that. And if he would have us fight for our survival, so be it. It's what we've been doing all along.
Much like Ultima himself, it would seem. His new world being naught but a means to survive. And so, we must contend to decide which of us shall inherit the land. Should Ultima prevail, it will mean death for us all. Of that, we can be certain. But even should he fail, what world awaits us? A withered, godless place, where our newfound freedom will most like prove a chain in itself.
Well, there may be, but a chain can always be broken. As long as one has the will to break it, it won't be easy. It may take generations, centuries of suffering. And that is, if everyone plays their part. But it will happen. And when it does, it will be on our terms. That is the world that awaits us.
Indeed. And what better world could one wish for?
But first, we have to reach that crystal.
Then it's a good thing I have wings.
You can barely stand, let alone fly. And only the Founder knows what horrors await in those skies. You certain about this?
Am I certain? I am the Phoenix. I will do what I must. This is our fight. Remember?
Really?
All right. I yield. But only what you must, yes. I am still your sworn shield.
That you are.
And what of my wings? Lest you forget, you go to stand against a god. I would not have you succumb to fatigue before the fight begins. Ifrit. Your brother mentioned that some few of the dominants who had lost their power to you were still able to prime. Is that true?
It is. But their icons no longer submitted to their will.
Then mine will have to be stronger. That you both might save your strength for the battle to come.
You don't have to do this.
If you do, there's a chance you might lose all you have left.
And what have I but regret? My life ended in the Dominion. I fear death no more. Besides, I would have words with Ultima. He has much to answer for.
What do we do?
We are in your debt, Dion.
We can speak of debts when this is over.
So we're going in there? Okay.
When? Speak to the command, he knows he's not coming back. Has come to terms with that.
That doesn't mean that we have to, does it, Kaif?
I have to talk to Jill. I only hope she understands.
Wow.
That might not be such a bad idea. This is it, Jill. You know what I have to do? Why I have to do it? There's no turning back now. This is where our journey was leading us. Where it will end, for better or worse.
I could pray to Metia for you. But you'll be all right, won't you, Clive? You always are.
I did promise we'd watch the moon together.
I'll be waiting.
It's a dangerous world out there. It's rubbing me blind, you know. It'd better all be here. Come again. Or don't. I'm not much bothered either way.
Where do I go?
Oh, Clive.
Of course. Another time.
Where am I going? Yeah. I go to the map.
Clive, if you see my dad up there, tell him you were right to leave his legacy with you.
Tell him he'll be in the front row. There's no way he'd miss this. Well, behave yourself, Mitt.
We'll see.
So, you're in charge now, Gav.
And what does Taya have to say about that? Come back before she finds out, eh?
Yeah.
Coyote. I'm sorry.
Your Grace, I shall pray for your safe return.
That's kind of you, but you should pray he took his medicine. I didn't spend all night grinding herbs for his lordship to leave them on his nightstand. Again.
You needn't fear, Lady Dyer. And thank you.
See that your brother comes back in one piece. Or, at most, two. Any more and you can heal him yourself.
I'll keep that in mind.
Well, there's nothing to say that hasn't already been said. But that's never stopped me before, so just you do what needs doing. And don't worry about us.
We'll do our best, Uncle.
I'll be well.
If that is all?
Not quite.
Jill, what's up?
It's time, isn't it?
It is. Take care of him. And you. You take care of her too, boy.
Don't forget, Clive. We all choose our own path. Believe in yours. I do.
I'll be back. I promise.
What you can say, Jill? Reply, Jill.
I know.
Oh my God.
I love you too. Isn't that? Time to go.
Now, we have a god to kill.
What? Thank you.
Hold on, Joshua!
Already am.
So, this is Origin.
A far cry from heaven.
Where it all began. Where it all begins. Our Ark. Your architect.
But in you.
There you are.
It was here that we slumbered. Here that we waited for centuries, clinging to our decrepit shell for fear that we might have need of it once again. But you have come at last. And now we shall be truly complete.
Oh, but I am you.
Well?
There's three of us, and one of him. Let's make it count.
Whoa. Why? Go, Bowen! What?
No.
The founder.
Did I mention you look terrible?
That makes two of us.
Oh, I'll be all right.
Leon. take my hand.
I told you, I'd be...
Oh my God.
Come on.
Thank you.
Press on.
Always.
You just why you wanna jump.
Sorry about Dion.
Don't be. Please. He did what he had to do.
And it's time we did the same. Should we stop?
Because of the cough. No, I think we're past that, Clive.
I suppose we are.
That light, so cold, so empty. We're close, aren't we?
It seems that way.
Yep.
But I don't want to think what could be waiting
We're
for us.
We're close to the
think instead of those waiting for us at home.
I mean, dear. Now what? If they're those...
They can't be.
But they are. This is the Nexus. A wellspring of life. Yours and ours. As we watch the world stumble slowly to its dark end, it was here we pledged a new beginning. And now, with the ether we have harvested,
now
I shall raise my kin from their eternal slumber. That together, we may usher in a new age of reason.
Nah.
This was never about creation. Only self-preservation. You condemned an entire world so that you alone might escape death alone.
Yeah.
Him alone. Life. I think I understand. He...
lifeblood from the depths of the earth unto this very chamber, and thus would they labor still, long after their work was done, had you not set them free.
You meant for us to destroy the Mother Crystals. It's what you wanted all along.
You have our gratitude, Newthor. In this you have served us well. You have both served us well. Welcome home, brother.
Joshua.
I thought it was me, but it wasn't my grasp that grew weaker. It was theirs that grew stronger.
Another one?
Joshua! No!
And now, we can become one.
Possessed of the destructive flames of Ifrit and the healing flames of the Phoenix. This, I once believed, would be Ultima's true form. But I was wrong. I see it now. Why you will never become Ultima's vessel.
Hold on.
Listen to me, Clive. Remember the murals? People once knew that Ultima was their god. That he created them. And they worshipped him, prayed to him, looked to him for guidance. In vain. In vain. For he did not listen, did not acknowledge our will. And so we strayed from his path to forge one of our own. So absorbed was he in his own desires, so driven by his own will alone, that he shunned the one thing that could have made him truly powerful. Faith. The same faith people now place in you. Faith that you will fulfill their dream, Sid's dream, of creating a better world for us. Faith that you will follow in Father's footsteps and save those who need saving most. Faith that you will answer Jill's plea to save yourself. The difference is, Clive, you chose to listen, and that is what has steeled our bonds. Bonds that helped you stand firm when Ultima's pull was at its strongest. His power may be absolute, but so is ours. And so will yours be. With my light in your heart, not even a god might stop us.
Joshua! Don't do it, you're...
Enough, Clive. My body is too far gone. If the wound does not take me, the curse will.
Thank you.
was the feeling.
I have always been proud to call you my shield. But now, it is the world that needs you. Thank you, Clive, for being my brother.
And thus does the final piece fall into place. The incantation primed, but one task remains: to empty the vessel. Even now, you would deny the inevitable.
As we always have, and always will. My sword, I swear, to shield the Firebird's flame forevermore.
Big deal. esto?
Conceited fool. Centuries have I waited for this moment in which I might revel in my creation, only to find it profaned and stolen. It must be cleansed. Endures.
Because it's not so easily broken.
But it can be broken. And I shall see it so. For such is my will.
Try it.
Me.
I sense more here than mere will. Is this Logos? Have you truly become free?
Yeah.
No, I forbid it. You are not a god. You are but flesh and bone. You are not one of us. I created you, all of you. And what is mine is mine to destroy.
Not me.
Once perhaps. But we are no longer yours.
Exactly.
Our flames are our own, and they burn as one!
Damned is the slave.
enough, huh? You can't find me anymore? Funny enough. Yeah.
My will is inviolable.
Something is wrong. You're afraid. You always have been. From the moment the Blight exposed what you were, weak. You conceived us to prove otherwise. But the result shook you to the core. For in us you saw yourself. And realized we had the potential to be more than you could ever be. And so you turned your back on your creation. Your back on the world, like the coward you are.
You think you know me? You know nothing, Logos. Nothing.
Logos. I don't want to fight the game.
I stand above you, my rebirth complete. And you for your divine for the price.
One.
An eternity of anguish.
My question. Pain, suffering. You have none of these. But we have. So we know what they grant. They bring us together. And that makes us strong.
The power of an arm.
Yeah.
Come on!
The altar at which you pray.
Mine are the eyes that look down upon you all.
And yet still you cannot see. You are no better than us. We are one and the same.
We are not the same.
Five days.
So sure of your place atop the world, you refuse to acknowledge those below. You chose to remain alone. And so you shunned the one thing that could have made you stronger. Pushed away the hands that could have raised you higher.
I do not need you, you or anyone.
And that is where we are different. I could not have made it here on my own. I carry with me the hopes and dreams of my brothers, my sisters. And it is they who will give me the strength to end your reign.
I cannot end.
Do you imagine will befall this world now that you have gained your precious freedom?
I honestly don't know. But I doubt it will be pretty. A sorry tale of sin and suffering, hardship and pain.
And it was for this that you fought so fiercely? Why?
It's who we are. Fight. We survive. We endure. We don't need a reason. We are imperfect creatures. When we stumble, we reach for a shoulder to lean on. We fall, we stand back up. We see the horizon, ever out of reach, and still we march on. Certain the answers lie just beyond. That is our way.
My congratulations. Relish this victory, knowing that you have but delayed the inevitable. Your world is already dead. May you enjoy an eternity. Blackened.
shit. No one. Oh. Are you allowed, Joshua? Nope. How are you gonna get involved then? Oh yeah, you are Phoenix. What is that? Oh, Joshua.
See Elton's legacy.
Wow. Wow. Yeah. Game still on the next game. See you all on the next game. He died. At the end. How's he? Life is gone.
journey in.
There's more! Who's that? Who is that?
Every time. Will you light it? Yes, mother. You see? Well done. Be a good lad and play with your brother until supper.
Hurry! It might be the next Final Fantasy. Another starts.